This week, our travels take us to Estes Park, Colorado, where I'll talk with author, horseman, and black belt martial artist Mark Rashid about how he incorporates Aikido into his horsemanship and riding program.
So get comfortable, kick your boots off, and join me. This is The Horse Show, and I'm Rick Lamb.
Horses need grain.
Not true. Research has shown that equine grain-associated disorders can be a threat to domestic horses. That's why Glow for Life feeds from ADM Alliance Nutrition go against the grain with premium low-starch, high-fat, high-fiber formulations to feed horses the way they're meant to eat, for life. For a limited time, get a free customized feeding plan for your horse at growstrong.com. That's G-R-O-strong.com.
When customers talk, Richie listens. And the Omni 10 automatic waterer has just what customers want. Extra size and strength, total heat coverage, large access panel, stainless steel trough, and Richie's famous fast refill valve. Like all Richie waterers, the Omni 10 is durable, reliable, and comes with a 10-year warranty. Learn more at richiefount.com. And relax, Richie waters them right.
One of the most interesting and thought-provoking people I've met has become a good friend, Mark Rashid. I thought it was time for you to meet him. I did quite a bit of that.
Mark, it's been about 10 years that you and I have known one another, and about 10 years that you've been talking about the concept of the passive leader.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like you to share that with our audience. I think it's a pretty profound concept and something that's very, very useful.
Okay. Watching herds over the years, I've just been real lucky in that I've been able to work with a lot of big herds in hundreds of horses throughout the years. And what I noticed was that there is an alpha horse that's kind of the boss of the herd that pushes the other horses around. And over the years, what I've heard is that during training, we want to become that alpha leader. And what I found just in watching the horses was that it was that alpha horse that was always left off by himself. You know, he'd push all the other horses away, and then he'd be left by himself.
Wasn't a very popular guy.
Not a real popular fella, or mare. And so what would end up happening is that it would create this dynamic within the herd. And there were, in bigger herds, there's several of these, you know, horses. And what I found was that while that was true, while there was that alpha kind of boss horse, what I also saw was that there was another horse in the herd, or a number of other horses, that were more quiet, and the other horses would actually follow that horse. The alpha horse, that boss horse, like I said earlier, very seldom are they the ones that the herd is going to follow, the other members of the herd are going to follow. Not by choice anyway. And I've often thought, you know, I don't see why I would want to emulate that behavior, you know, in training, because it's for me, it doesn't seem like I would like to be the one left alone.
Now, when you started emulating the passive leader in the herd, how did that work out for you?
Pretty well. And really what it boiled down to was just consistency, being consistent every day, day in and day out. Didn't matter what you were offering them. And there's a lot of times, you know, when we're doing clinics around the country or wherever, that people will say, well, you know, those old cowboys, you know, it's that old cowboy way. But by golly, those horses work for those guys every day and still do.
As for using the passive leader as a model for our human behavior with a horse, the passive leader, it seems to me, doesn't really have an agenda. That's kind of part of what defines him, isn't it? That he just kind of goes along and gets along, and he doesn't really set out to get something done with the other horses. Where with us, with horses, we've always got an agenda, we've got a plan, there's something that we want to do. And by the same token, we also need to discourage behaviors that we don't want to see repeated in the horse. So how do you incorporate that in the passive leader model?
Well, it's the same within the herd. The word passive, it doesn't have to do with the way the horse behaves. It has to do with the way the horse is chosen. It's not that they are aggressively going after things. It's that they're leading by their behavior. Those horses discourage behavior they don't want. You know, but it's almost always self-defense. Not always, but almost always self-defense, where they will need a horse is coming in a little too close, and they may pin an ear or turn their head or move towards or do whatever, but very seldom do they actually go after. They will if the other horse keeps pushing. So, but it's very clear, whereas like with an alpha horse, a lot of times what they will do is they will just go after you anyway. You know, even if you've backed off, they'll go after you and keep going after.
Well, besides the passive leader, and this concept, as I said, you started talking to me about almost 10 years ago. So it's been rattling around in my brain for a while. But also that was kind of the beginning of another journey for you into Aikido, which is the Japanese martial art. Tell me what has come of that and how you've related that to horsemanship.
Well, Aikido is, like you say, it's a Japanese martial art, and it's a defensive art. And there are virtually no offensive moves in Aikido. And really the only way it works is if you are soft. You cannot be tough and strong, and I mean you can be, but you can't use a lot of muscle and have Aikido work well.
Interesting.
So horsemanship is the same way, at least it is for me, that what we're, you know, the softer you are, the easier things become. Aikido, translated, means the way of harmony. And it's not just the way of harmony within, you know, what you're just doing here. It's you know, harmony in the universe.
Now, how are you tying that in to horses and horsemanship?
Well, anybody who's been on a horse knows that they can muster a tremendous amount of energy from time to time. And what most of us try to do is fight that energy. You know, we try to stop it or whatever. And a lot of what we're talking about when we're working with horses is, I liken it to a river that's going downstream. As long as the river's moving, everything's fine. But if you put up a dam in the river, and it's not a very good dam, but you put a dam in the river, it doesn't stop the river. What it does is the river flows and it gets up to the dam and then it starts backing up. The energy of the river doesn't stop. Eventually, if the dam isn't very good, it's going to break. You're going to have a big mess upstream, you're going to have a big mess downstream. So the idea is to try and allow that energy to keep moving and just direct it as if it were still in the banks. And anytime within horsemanship or working with dogs or people or whatever, it's very difficult to change behavior if you don't offer something else in return. So with horses, a lot of what we have a tendency to do is say, you need to stop that. But we don't give them an alternative. And as a result, that behavior doesn't actually stop. It just keeps coming back and keep coming back. So
now you've got some exercises that you do on the ground that help people kind of get the concept of softness and your center and so forth. Can you show me some of those?
Absolutely.
All right, let's go.
Let's go.
Coming up next, Mark Rashid shows me the power of visualization.
This spot right here. Okay.
And we get another nutrition nugget from ADM Alliance Nutrition. Stay with us.
For growth, for reproduction, for work.
Tired of the difficult to apply, messy, and stain-prone thrush treatments?
Farnham has the answer.
New ThrushX Thrush Treatment 8 Aerosol eliminates messy drips, runs, and stains with its unique ability to spray upside down. Its quiet, no-pump aerosol technology creates a continuous, consistent spray that only goes where you need it. Plus, it contains copper naphthenate, the same active ingredient as competing brands. Visit FarnhamHorse.com.
Red Brand, the number one name in ag fencing, has products specifically designed to keep your horse safe and secure. Non-climb fence, with its unique 2-inch by 4-inch spacing, prevents stepping through and uses the smooth side of our square deal knot to protect coats from injury. V-mesh fence uses a diamond mesh weave to prevent hooves or legs from becoming caught in the fence and flexes on impact. Both feature 100% American-made zinc-coated wire to stand up to harsh weather and heavy pressure. For free installation videos and to find a dealer near you, visit redbrand.com today.
Is your horse a star?
Enter America's favorite trail horse competition from ACTA and find out. Auditions are in April. Visit ACTHA.US for details. Win your share of up to $100,000 in cash and prizes. Meet celebrities and be on national TV. Is your horse America's favorite trail horse? Just one way to find out. Visit ACTHA.US and sign up to audition. Do it for you. Visit ACTHA.US or call 877-99-ACTA. Imagine a warehouse with everything for your horse. That's Jeffers Equine. Jeffers is the best equine catalog with more than 25,000 items, same-day free shipping, the happiest customers, and the lowest prices guaranteed. Save now on Jeffers Ivermectin Deworming Paste, just $2.49 a tube. Call 1-800-JEFFERS or visit jefferseequine.com to get your free catalog. Equine specialists are standing by. Jeffers Equine, earning your trust right here in America since 1975.
The center. Mm-hmm. How do you get that across to people?
Okay, well, it's real easy. You mind if I touch your forehead?
Go right ahead.
Okay, here we go. This spot right here.
Okay.
So you feel that spot?
Yes, I do.
Okay. I want you to think about that spot. Now, I'm going to put my hands on your shoulders. I'm going to try and move you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay. Okay.
I'm a pushover.
Okay, there you go. Okay, second one is right here.
Okay, a little lower then.
A little lower then. Okay. That spot right there. And I'm going to do exactly the same thing using the same amount of pressure. Okay? Okay. Much stronger this time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the third one is just below your belt buckle. We're going to use your belt buckle as the spot.
Okay?
So I want you to think about that spot.
Okay.
See, now I'm using more pressure. So you feel the difference between those three spots?
Yes, I do.
So what we did was we moved your center from here to here to here.
So what's going on in your mind really matters?
It does, yeah. When people are riding, when they've got their when they're all up in their head, you know, they're thinking about, you know, they're going down the road, they're thinking about the dogs barking, or, you know, the kid's got a bad grade in school, or whatever, you know. Hope my horse doesn't spook, you know, that kind of thing. They're up here, which causes us to be very unstable, you know, physically unstable. The second one we did was here. Okay, this one down here is equivalent to riding from the heart. So when you're riding from the heart, you're thinking about, you know, what a beautiful day. I really like my horse. You know, things are really going well today. This is riding from the heart. But the third one, the place from your power, you're taking away the thought, and you're putting it here, and you're putting everything here, the power from your center. And when you do this part, then this becomes, everything becomes much, much stronger, okay? So, and more balanced and more intact. So when we do that there, you know, we go here, this becomes really easy, okay?
Wow.
That spot becomes, that one thing becomes tremendously stronger. So this, all I'm thinking about is being low, bottom weighted, okay? So, for instance, I've got some exercise on softness.
Okay.
Okay, you want to give this a try?
You bet, absolutely.
Okay, for these, I want to bring in Chrissy. She's my partner, and she's really good.
Hi, Chrissy.
Hi. Good friend of mine. So, for these, we're going to show you the power of softness.
Okay.
Okay? So, because you're a pretty big guy, and she's not as big, and you work out, and she doesn't.
Well, okay.
She's going to do this exercise with you. Let's switch sides here. You come here, she can come here. Okay, now what she's going to do is she's going to hold her arm out like this and she's going to make a fist.
Okay.
Okay, now what you're going to do is you're going to put your one hand here, mm-hmm. one hand here, mm-hmm. and you're going to see if you can bend her arm.
Okay, okay? I'm going to try and bend her arm.
You're going to try
That's
and bend
the idea.
Her arm.
I'm sorry, I've got cold hands. All right, are we ready?
Go for it.
Just go ahead.
Wow, she's strong.
But the arm bent, didn't it?
It did.
Okay, now Chrissy's going to do something different this time. What she's going to be doing is she is going to soften her arm.
Yeah, she's not flexing that bicep like she should.
Right, she's going to soften her arm. And she's going to be thinking of this arm as a fire hose. The water's coming up through the ground, through her leg, and it's shooting out that arm. Okay?
And I'm supposed to do the same thing?
Do the same thing.
Okay.
Taylor, are you ready there, Chrissy?
Ready.
That's very different.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all the power of the
power
of the mind.
Focus. Right. So our job is to stay focused, keep a quiet mind, and only think about those things that are important right now, as opposed to thinking about things that are important there. One more.
Okay.
Make a fist.
Okay.
Be really strong. Okay, very difficult to move your arm. Mm-hmm. You're tight, I'm soft.
It just goes, there's just nothing for me to push against.
Right.
Softness is not weakness.
No, it's not.
And I guess that's a key point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, softness is not weakness. And that's the same thing with passive leadership. Being a passive leader does not mean we give everything away. It simply means we work consistently. You know, we're working together to try and accomplish the same thing. Okay? And to have that horse choose that option as opposed to choosing a different option.
Can you demonstrate this to me on a horse?
Absolutely.
Let's do it.
Okay. Well, this is a horse we just got a couple months ago, I guess it was, and I haven't done a lot with him, but he's off the track, and he's a pretty nice fellow. When we first got him, he was real tight, very upside down. Couldn't find a way to put his head down, and kind of
pretty calm now.
Yeah, he's doing a little better. What we've been doing with him is kind of what we've been talking about, and just treating him. Offering him some softness and seeing what he can come up with as far as being able to decide whether or not he wants to be soft or go the way he was going.
Why don't you show us some of the things you've been doing with him?
Absolutely. All right, well, we'll just start out at the beginning. What we were talking about was working from a little softer place and offering the horse softness. And when we got this guy, he was very high-headed. If I asked him to stop, his head went up, and there was no stop. If I asked him to go, we went really, really fast. And we didn't have much as far as turning goes. It was just, everything was forward and fast. So I wanted to just show you just a couple of the things that we were doing and how that affects the horse. One of the things that we talked about earlier was how you tighten, if you tighten something, it affects the horse. You see, all of a sudden my horse changed his movement. Now, all I did was I just tightened a muscle. And you saw what happened was all of a sudden he had trouble moving. Okay? Now, if I soften up, he changes. Okay? If I tighten up, he slows. Right? For every muscle that I contract, I tighten up, he has to tighten a corresponding muscle, which affects his movement. So just that, so you see where it doesn't, if I can use a lot of cue, I can use, my leg, and still he has trouble moving. Or I can soften everything up and just go. He starts breathing. Okay? So, just to start with, I wanted to show you just how, once we start to tighten things, so if I just tighten my fist, he slowed down. So we open everything up, horse can move again. So if we want to, say, move into a trot, for instance, no leg, we just ask for the trot. We want to walk again, we don't have to pick the reins up, we just walk. So between the two of us, if I want to move, what I will do is I just move like I would if I were on the ground. So if I wanted to walk from one place to another quickly, then this is the feel I would get. I would give myself this feel. In fact, let me show you. So if I'm walking slowly, okay, this has a certain feel to your body. Okay? If you're walking quicker, that has a certain feel. Okay? If we trot, that has a certain feel, okay? So, and if we stop, that has a certain feel. Now, one of the things that we see a lot of times with folks is they stop, they push their feet into the stirrups, they hunker on down. And that's great, but what it does is it takes all of the energy out of the horse, takes all the energy out of the rider. So it takes more to get the horse going again. So if you remember the picture we just gave you, the slow walk, okay, now without any leg, the faster walk, okay, and again without any leg, the trot, and then we go back to the walk. No reins. So our idea is to work with him using the least amount of energy possible. But I just wanted to show you some of the little stuff that we can accomplish. And
I appreciate that. Thank you, Mark.
Absolutely. Thank you, Rick.
And now, Nutrition Nuggets, brought to you by ADM Alliance Nutrition.
In a horse's diet, what is the difference between energy and protein? I'm with Dr. Judy Reynolds, equine nutritionist, ADM Alliance Nutrition. Dr. Reynolds, what's the difference?
Well, actually, that's a great question because it's very confusing to horse owners. They seem to have a lot of problem understanding this. The energy is actually the fuel. It's like the gas that goes into the car. We get it from carbohydrates and fats. So the sugars, the starches, and the fibers are all carbohydrates. And then the fats also help provide the energy. So the horses need the energy for basic movements, to stay warm, for growth, for reproduction, for work, all those different things. It's just like fuel. Then if we're looking at the protein, and we're using that car analogy again, that would be more like the parts. So the engine and the carburetor and all the different parts of the car would be more like the protein. Now, when you've got a young horse, that young horse is growing. So you'd think they would need a lot more parts to grow, so they need more protein. That's kind of a good way to remember it. Then when we get to that older horse is going to need more energy the more they work. So not much energy if doing nothing, a lot more energy if doing a lot of work. But that older horse, that mature horse, is still going to have some basic breakdown and wear and tear of the parts. Just like every once in a while, you may have to take the car to the shop and get it fixed. You still have to have a basic amount of protein for that horse. So they all need some of it. They need different amounts depending on what type of horse, what breed of horse, what kind of work, and all those different factors are into it. But they're separate, they're used for different functions, and they're both very important for the horse's diet.
Great way to explain that. Thank you, Dr. Reynolds.
Oh, thank you.
To learn more about ADM Alliance Nutrition, visit growstrong.com. That's growstrong.com.
In the coming months, Rick will appear at these events, and he'd like to meet you. Up-to-the-minute details are available at thehorseshow.com. Thehorseshow.com is also a great way to listen to Rick's radio shows or buy signed copies of his books. There's something new for horse lovers every week at thehorseshow.com.
Is your horse a star? Enter America's Favorite Trail Horse Competition from ACTA and find out. Auditions are in April. Visit ACTHA.US for details. Win your share of up to $100,000 in cash and prizes. Meet celebrities and be on national TV. Is your horse America's Favorite Trail Horse? Just one way to find out. Visit ACTHA.US and sign up to audition. Do it for you. Visit ACTHA.US or call 877-99-ACTA.
Meet the Ultimate Trail Saddle, the Australian-style saddle from Down Under Saddle Supply. Its deep seat and knee pads mean greater security and comfort for you. And Down Under's free custom adjustment means a better fit for your horse. With more than 1,000 Aussie saddles in stock, Down Under Saddle Supply has the style and price you want with fast shipping and a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go Aussie and you'll never go back. Shop for your Australian saddles, tack, clothing, and more at downunderweb.com. That's downunderweb.com.
When customers talk, Richie listens. And the Omni 10 automatic waterer has just what customers want. Extra size and strength, total heat coverage, large access panel, stainless steel trough, and Richie's famous fast refill valve. Like all Richie waterers, the Omni 10 is durable, reliable, and comes with a 10-year warranty. Learn more at richiefount.com. And relax, Richie waters them right.
Next week, I ride with the backcountry horsemen of Georgia.
We spend a lot of time out here in this great wonderland.
And learn how they're helping keep wilderness areas open for all of us.
We're talking about weekly service, so that's a big commitment.
So have fun, ride safely, and I'll see you next time. For The Horse Show, I'm Rick Lamb.
Smile on your face, I'll keep everything in place. You can count on me to take a stand, 'cause I'm your handyman.
Closed captioning is presented by Muddy Creek Rain Gear, lightweight, breathable, and truly waterproof. Visit muddycreek.net.